Now, just some words, because now I'm going to introduce Marta Verginella, that is the principal investigator of IRENI project. And I want to really warmly thanks her to involve us in this wonderful workshop. And just a minute, because I have to thank really other people that collaborated in this organization. Because we have been a double team from the University of Ljubljana, from the University of Trieste, and you can imagine how we were thrilled in these days, because you are always so. And I want to thank warmly Polona Kapla, Neja Turdin, Paolo Feluga, and Elisabetta Tigami-Sava, and also Matteo Perissinotto. This is our bridge from Trieste to Ljubljana in this organization and so on. Because we are going to be able to see there today. Now, I think it's time to introduce Marta. Maybe we do not need to introduce her CV and so on. You can find everything, but on the book, on the little book, it's you will find your bag. But Marta is the second year now of this project. And we are working together as a side, and I'm very honored to be involved as an outside collaborator in this project. And I think that I see that step after step, with all these workshops, we are going deeper into this question, that is what men transitions, post-war transitions for women through the various aspects of their lives, their work, their families, and so on. So Marta, please, I'll give you the floor, and thanks a lot to be here with us.
Thank you for this nice presentation and introduction. Esteemed Vice Rector, Lorenza Raga, dear head Professor Head Pezzosi, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, welcome, Dobrodan, buongiorno, good morning. It gives me great pleasure that our first workshop, Postwar Transitions, work in the scope of the RSC IREN under my guide leadership, is held in Trieste in collaboration with the University of Trieste and Department of Humanistic Sciences. I am delighted that we are here, not only because Trieste, with its broad border region, is included in the search within our project, entitled Post-War Transition in Gender Perspective, the case of the Northeastern Adriatic region, but also because I completed the undergraduate part of my studies of history here, or in the ancient of the department of history. The period was of extraordinary importance for me, further working history, and because a few members of the research team were shaped in this department. In short, we are at the location and in the city that are closely connected to what to that which is emerging within our project that is based at the University of Ljubljana. The first two workshops, the first one addressing the subject of transition women and polemics, the second, violence inflicted on women in transition, were held in Ljubljana. It is thus not a coincidence that we have decided to organize the third workshop, which is dedicated to work in Trieste, in the city that was from the second half of the 18th century to the mid-20th century a powerful economic pole of attraction for its broader surroundings, including the Galician, Friulian, Carnolian, and Istrian area. Within the expansion of the port, commercial and industrial activities, Trieste saw an increase in the influx of employees from its immediate or remote hinterland and, as indicated by demographic researches, the dimension of women immigration was similar to that of men. Women were employed in manufacturers, factories, tradesmen's workshop, and most of all as maids, cooks, and or wet nurses. Many women from the city surroundings sold farm produce and artisan products. The process of modernization and nationalization of society gave middle-class women the opportunity to join the ranks of teachers, officers, office clerks, individual women, also of entrepreneurs. This is a process of women entering new professional profiles, which was mostly possible due to their schooling. These processes present thus happening elsewhere in Europe. In the northern Adriatic, these processes were subject to brutal geopolitical changes both after First World War I or World War I and II, and partly also in the 90s. Wars provided employment for many women. Today, we will attempt to determine to what extent did the end of the war mean also the end of women's employment, or what changes did transitions cause in the field of women's work in the area that is subject to our research in Italy, Slovenia, Croatia, and Austria, as well as in the broader European space. Before wishing us a successful work, I would like to express my special thanks to my friend and colleague, Tulia Katara, for supporting and co-shaping this workshop, and most of all to Colonna Kapler and Matteo Persinotto, who put a lot of efforts into organizing this workshop, alongside other members of the Irin project and the Trieste organizational team, making sure that it's conducted in the best possible atmosphere. Thank you all. I wish us good and successful work and also a nice permanence in Trieste.